Welcome to Teddy Physics. Why are coils of electric toasters and electric irons made up of an alloy rather than pure metal? So the answer is very simple, because the resistivity of alloys is higher than metals. Because resistivity of alloys is higher than metals. For example, if you take a resistivity of iron, so approximately it will come 10 into 10 power minus 8, okay, ohm meter. And if you take a resistivity of nichrome, so it's an alloy, so an alloy made up of nickel, chromium, manganese and iron. So this one, the resistivity is 100 into 10 power minus 6 ohm meter. So why the resistivity is very important or matter here means, because the resistance depends upon resistivity. That is the main thing here. So if you see, the resistance is equal to rho L by A. Here if you see, the resistance is directly proportional to resistivity. So the more resistivity indicates the more resistance. If you are changing resistivity indicates you are changing resistance here. So we need a high resistance material there. Why high resistance means, for example, if you take this one here, a material conductor, okay, which is having high resistance. Now what will happen here? If it is having high resistance, indicates it won't allow electrons to pass through it simply, easily. So it will obstruct it, stop it. So it do not allow the electrons to pass through it simply, easily. So it will obstruct it. So collisions will happen, more collisions will happen. So indicates that what will happen because of that collisions, more heat energy will be generated. Because more collisions will be there, automatically more heat energy will be generated. So because of that, we can easily cook our meals. If less collisions are there, that means what? Less resistance will be there. That means we can't cook out, because that much of heat won't be generated for using this. This is one reason. So the resistivity of alloys is higher than metals. So we can increase the resistance of that substance. Automatically, we can use the heat generated by that material for cooking purposes. This is one. And second one is, of course, you already know this thing, like alloys don't melt at huge temperatures. I mean, like metals, they simply can melt in low temperatures also, but alloys, they won't, they will have a high melting point. Don't melt at huge temperatures also. So that means melting point of alloys is very high. That's what I simply want to say. Okay, guys, thank you.